Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this video, I want to show you the best settings for frequency separation in Photoshop. All right, let's go to File, Open. I'm going to open the frequency sep file, and I want to show you the basic settings for frequency separation. Frequency separation is a way to do skin smoothing without losing skin texture. And the way you do that is you separate the low frequency and the high frequency, which is the skin texture. And then you just blur the low frequency while leaving the high frequency alone. So let's see how that plays out in practice. So first, our low frequency, we're going to blur. And for this, I'm going to use a 3-pixel blur, hit OK. Then with our high frequency layer selected, we're going to go to Image, Apply Image, which is somewhere around here. There it is. OK, and then in here, we're going to use the layer called Low Frequency. We want to make sure the channel's RGB. We want the blending to be subtract, the opacity to be 100. We want the scale to be 2. And then we want the offset to be 128. Let's hit OK. Then we're going to put this on linear light. Now, the combination of these two layers, if we turn it on and off, should be visually identical to this layer. And you can see that it is. But we've now separated our high frequency, meaning our skin textures, from our low frequency. And what we can do is blend our low frequency using either Gaussian Blur or other tools to create smoother skin. So before I show you the settings for the Mix Brush or the Gaussian Blur, what I want to do is show you the settings for a 16-bit file. So here you can see this is 8-bit. We're going to call this 8-bit. But if I wanted to do the same thing in a 16-bit file, my settings are going to be slightly different. So let's go to Image, Mode, change this to 16-bit. And I'm going to make a copy. We're going to call this 16 Lo-Fi. And then we'll make another copy and call this 16 Hi-Fi. And we're going to blur this the same amount. So let's go Gaussian Blur. There you go. And then with our 16 Hi-Fi, I'm going to go to Image, Apply Image. I want to make sure that the Lo-Fi is our source. And for this, when you're doing 16-bit, you're actually going to invert this. So we're going to go Invert, and we're going to change this to Add. And then we're going to change the scale to 2 and then hit OK. And then again, put this on linear light. And then this at 16-bit will have exactly the same result. Here you can see, I zoom in, the two look the same. So that's the settings that you use for frequency separation. And I'll pop them up on the screen here. If you want to pause, take a look at it, make a screen copy, download it, whatever you want. Those are the settings that you use. Now, I've seen two primary ways that people do Gaussian blurring, blurring or smoothing of the skin underneath. One is using Gaussian Blur. I'm going to show you that technique on the 16-bit. And then I'll show you my preferred version on this 8-bit one. So for the 16-bit, what you're going to do is go on to the lasso tool. And you're going to select areas of the skin like this. And you have two options here. You can either feather your selection before you do it. So maybe put in 50 here. Make your selection, and you can see if I hit Q that it's already feathered. And then with this Lo-Fi, I can go to Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, And as I blur, look what happens. The skin starts to become nice and smooth underneath like that. But because our high frequency is on top, we still retain that skin texture. So that's that method. And basically what you would do here is just go around your entire image and just, you know, repeat that Gaussian blur on various parts of your image, avoiding obviously these hard edges because you don't want to blur those. But that gives you an idea of how to do this. You can see the effect is pretty strong, and because it's so strong, kind of looks fake. Obviously you can take down the amount of blur and so forth, but generally I don't find this system of doing frequency separation to be very intuitive. My preferred method is actually using a brush, and for that we're going to go to the mixer brush tool. Should be under your brushes. If it's not, you may have to go here to edit toolbar. It is a tool that's not often used. This is the only thing I ever use it for, but for this it's really good. Basically what you're doing is you're creating a Gaussian blur brush. So let's go here. For starters, we want to make sure this is on clean brush. And that means it's not going to have a brush that's loaded with colors, because you don't want that. You just want to blur the image underneath the brush. So clean brush, make sure this is not turned on. That what it does is it loads the brush when you start painting. So make sure that's off. And then you do want this turned on. This will clean the brush every time you start a new stroke. So that's the settings for those. And then here, you may see custom. These are some presets for these here. And the best preset to start with is heavy mix. That sets everything correctly except for the mix, which you're just going to change to 50. Otherwise, the brush is now ready. And the great thing about this is I can change the size of the brush as I'm working, depending on which area of her face I want to target. So if I'm targeting a big area, I can have a big brush, kind of just start painting, and you'll see that that's blurring the skin underneath. And then for the smaller areas, I can use a smaller brush like this. And because my flow is set to 25, each time I make a stroke, it's only blurring at 25% strength. So that means I can go over the same area if I want more blur. I can also turn down the flow if I want less blur to begin with, but I think 25 is a good starting point. And as you can see, I have way more control of how this is going to end up looking because I'm using a brush rather than just a Gaussian blur, which really you don't have much control of except for the amount and the edges of it. Whereas this, I have full control of the stroke direction, what I'm mixing, and all of that. So definitely my preferred method. And once you've done it, you normally just want to take the opacity down a little bit, maybe to 70%, and show through your original background so it doesn't look overly corrected. There you can see my using the mixer brush, and then here you can see using the Gaussian blur mesh method. I think the brush is a pretty similar effect, but I do think the brush gives you just more control over how you paint it. So that is my preferred method. There you go. That's how you do it. The one thing I want to say is, because frequency separation is something you'll use so often, it's a good idea to kind of put all these steps into an action. And I've done that with my Nucly actions. So if this is a 16-bit file, I'm going to select my 16-bit frequency separation and just hit go. Now I have my high frequency, low frequency, and my original all in a folder set called frequency separation. If you want to download these, I have included a link to them in the description. They're a purchase product, but you know, very helpful to have. Saves a lot of time. The one other thing I do have in here is I also have feather selection. So if your preferred method is using the Gaussian blur, and you don't want to feather your Gaussian blur, you can go in here and for a big selection like this, maybe feather at 150. And then for smaller selections here like this, you can just feather at 10%. Each time you play this action, it'll feather the selection more. So with the feather selections and the frequency separations, you have a lot of the tools that you generally are going to be using when you do frequency separation. And it just speeds up the workflow. So there you go. Those are my settings for frequency separation. Hopefully they'll be of use to you. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please subscribe to my channel, leave a like, leave a comment, share this video, do all that good stuff. And here's some other tutorials to check out. I'll see you next time.